And as Ms. Dennis shared earlier, the Port Maria High and Preparatory School warmly welcomes you to our Evangelistic Week or Expert Day, where you will hear from our schools, not just Port Maria High School, but from our schools this week as we showcase God, as we lift Him up, as we magnify His name. And this afternoon in particular, the students, the staff, the parents of the Port Maria High School will be leading out. So all our parents who are online on the Zoom platform and also on YouTube, you are warmly welcome. All our past and present parents and students, we are happy to have you here.
We are also delighted to have with us online our education director, Ms. Audrey Brown. We also have members from the Northeast Jamaica Conference worshiping with us tonight. And I'm sure our arms are extended way beyond Northeast. So for those of you who are joining us from the other conferences, we are happy to have you worshiping with us this afternoon. I am sure that the Lord has something wonderful lined up for you. I am sure that there will be a blessing for all of us. And as we invite the children to come, I know this week that they will be drawn closer to God. So to all my students, welcome. Welcome as you participate. Welcome as you listen and give support to your teammates. Have yourselves a wonderful evening. God bless you. And remember to let the children come to Jesus.
All right. Thank you very much, Mrs. Andrews. I'm sure that those who are tuned in are feeling very, very, very much welcome, and they are happy that they would have decided to join us this evening. Now, to set the tone for our worship experience, we have the Brumfields, who are teachers of our at our school, to lead out in the praise and worship segment. After which, a performer, Michaela Bailey, she will introduce the opening song.
Good afternoon once more. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you again for your grace and your mercy. We're asking, oh dear Father, that you be in our midst. Connect us even amidst the fact that we are connecting virtually. We are asking that your Holy Spirit will unite us, and that what we are gathered here for, to lift up your high and your holy name, and to draw others closer to you, that you will be glorified in our work, in all that we do this afternoon. Dear Father, as we go through this program, we're praying that your divine hand will be over everything that we do. You will be in our midst, to work in us, work on us, and work through us. Father, we're putting in your care the education department. And as we go, as we do thy work of bringing your children closer to you, we're asking that you will help us in this work. You will guide our hands, guide our minds, guide our hearts, and give us the instruments that we need to do your work. This we ask with thanksgiving, we pray in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. We sing a few songs to highlight our afternoon or evening, and we'll begin with Thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I'm
My heart forever is wandering. Promises of Christ. I wish.
Thank you so much for leading out in the praise and worship session. It was such a soul-stirring segment. Now, Michaela, it's over to you. Please take us through the opening song.
Our opening hymn is from hymn 109, When He Cometh. Sorry, 218. When he cometh, when he cometh to make up his jewels, all his jewels, precious jewels, his love and beauty, bright gems for his crown. He will gather the gems for his kingdom. All the pure ones, all the bright ones, his loved and his own. Like the stars of the morning, his bright crown adorning, they shall shine in their beauty, bright gems for his crown. Little children, who love their Redeemer, are the jewels, precious jewels, his loved and his own. Stars of the morning, his bright crown adorning, they shall shine in their beauty, bright gems for his crown. Adorning his red crown, adorning, they shall shine in his crown. For his crown.
Such beautiful singing that was. Thank you very much, Michaela. Now, I am wondering if anyone in who is tuned in can tell me to type in the chat how long the Port Maria High and Preparatory School has been in existence. Yes, how long? How many years? Since when has the school been established? Well, if you're not sure, and if you guessed right, let me share with you. The school was established in the year 1963. So we have been in existence for over 60 years, and that's a long time. I'm sure you would agree with me. And throughout the 60 years, we have touched many, many lives. And this evening, we have someone whose life the institution has touched in a remarkable way. I am speaking of Sister Sherlene Hicklin. She is a past student of the institution and also a current parent, She will now share how the Port Maria High and Preparatory School has impacted her life.
Thank you. Unfortunately, I'm not as old as it started, but I'm still above half of that. So I am grateful. Well, the impact of not just education, but Christian education on my life. When I started out at the Port Maria High School, I knew nothing about Seventh-day Adventists. Education. I was not grown up in a Christian home, so to speak. But how did I end up there? So I had my cousin, her dad and my mom, they were brother and sister. So we went all the way from kindergarten to, it was then all age school. So at grade six, which would have been PEP now, but I think it was the common entrance then, we were not successful at that time. And then we did the grade seven technical, still were not successful. We went on to grade nine, we still were not successful. So her parents were getting her enrolled in the Port Maria High School. Otherwise, it would have been, you know, a secondary school. So poor me, knowing nothing, but I am not going to be separating from my friends, from my cousin. So I have to get enrolled as well. And so we did. But in everything, and it was not until years and years and years later, I realized that God has a plan in everything, you know. So after we started school that September morning and we were settled in school, that's when we received letters that both of us were being accepted at our traditional high school of our choice. Unfortunately, then she left me, her parents took out the Seventh-day Adventist student and left the non-Seventh-day Adventist student there because my parents could not have afforded it. At that time, still, the Seventh-day Adventist had no impact on my life. the education had no impact on my life. But during the time of going to school, of course, I would have visited church then. After leaving school, that was the end of it for me. Church, no. That wasn't a part of my journey. And so my dad, who died a little before I graduated from school, and after that, my mother decided that she's going to accept the Sunday faith. And so occasionally I would have visited church with her, but it was not the same message that I received in school and that I received at church. And so church for me then was a no-no. Until some years later down, you know, I decided that I have to find my way now in church. And I started going back to the Seventh-day Adventist church. And I felt that this is where I belong. And so I gave my heart to God then. But it started off at the education area, Christian education. And so as I, you know, matured into life and I started to have a family of my own, well, yes, just a son, I was determined that he has to get a Christian education as well. But that didn't happen until in his high school years. And what prompted me even more was it was during the COVID that he started high school. And being online at home and was able to hear what is being taught. And I realized that school was only teaching him how to fit into this world. When I listened to the family life sessions, it's only teaching him how to fit into adulthood. When I listened to religious education, it wasn't telling me anything. And I'm like, if my son could have defended himself then with what is being taught, and I'm like, no. Christian education at a Seventh-day Adventist school, that has impacted my life so much. It has to impact my child as well. And so I couldn't wait for that first year to end because I didn't want to start him at the middle of the year. And from the March, I started to call and I started to question and I started to get involved because I knew that this is where my son belonged because it had impacted my life and it has to have an impact on his life as well. And so that's where it started out. The journey is not an easy one. It has been rough many, many, many a times. But I knew that God knows what is best. And if it had impacted me to fit into where I am right now, I know that parents who are here listening, if your child has not yet started, you need to get them started into our schools, into our institutions, if you need them to be fit for heaven. With me going there and going to school, I was able to see my sister first in the church, then her two children, my other sister, and my mother, who had been in the church for over 30 years, just years before she passed, she became a Seventh-day Adventist. And it all started out at the Christian institution. And I'm happy and I thank God that he did not allow us to get those results before we started out school that September morning. But because of the plan that he had, he allowed us first to start school, knowing that my parents was not able to change when we start off. And with that, over 30 years now, it still had that impact on me. It was one of the best set of teachers that I came in contact with. Students were great. We were like a family. And even now, I know that I can call teachers, unlike when my child was at other schools. So I would encourage parents, send their children to our institutions. It will fit them not only for this life, but for the life to come. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sister Hicklin. What a beautiful testimony that was. Let me just reiterate one thing that Mrs. Hicklin said a while ago, that Christian education, and not just Christian education, but Seventh-day Adventist Christian education does not only prepare our students for the life, for this life, but it also prepares our students for the life to come. So now we are at a special point in our program, and it was Ellen White who said that prayer is the key in the hand of faith to unlock heaven's storehouse. And here at the Port Maria High End Preparatory School, we love to pray. And we believe in prayer. And if you ask our students, they will tell you that every class session, before we start teaching the teachers, they start with prayer. Every class session, every day. And so therefore, as I said before, we believe in prayer. And right now, Mrs. Ramona Smith Andrews, our principal, will lead us into a special prayer session where we, at this time, will be focusing on our students who will be doing their PEP exams, the last round of the PEP exams, and also our fifth formers who will start their CSEC exams in the coming weeks.
Let us pray. Sovereign God, the creator of this universe, the master teacher, the great I am. I approach you, Lord, knowing quite well that you are King of Kings and you are Lord of Lords. Father, thank you. Thank you for the avenue that you have created where fallen human beings like us, can communicate with heaven, can communicate with a loving God who wants to talk to us. And this evening, Lord, we are happy to know that we can call on you, because you said in your words, we should call on you. We should ask, we should seek, we should knock, we should come and reason with you. And that is why we're here this afternoon. Father, we have all our students in our institutions. We have students from the Port Maria High and Prep School, from the Portland High and Prep School, from the Buff Bay Academy, and also stretching across the Seventh-day Adventist schools right across Jamaica, and also our public schools who will be doing their examinations, CSEC examination, mm-hmm. and PEP examination. Father, being the great master teacher, being the source of all knowledge, and being our wise, only true wise God, we seek you, Lord, on behalf of these your children. We're asking you, Lord, that you will have your own sweet way with them. Lord, I know that you're able to touch brain cells. I know that you're able to revive in them, Lord, that love for knowledge, that quest for knowledge. I know, Lord, that once they believe in you, as our motto says, with God in the lead, we must succeed. I know that once they believe in you, Lord, they will allow you to rule in their lives. So as they sit in those examination rooms, the things that they would have learned in class, the things that they would have studied even on their own, the things, Lord, that they They would have heard, by the way, that is very relevant to their examination. They'll be able to apply, Lord, when that time comes. Father, I pray that these children will not misinterpret any question, but as they look, Lord, you working in their lives will allow them to interpret every item. I know, Lord, that their success is our success, but greater than that, Lord, their success is your success. And it highlights the fact that there is a God who still exists in Israel. So, Father, do for them what they are unable to do for themselves and what we as teachers are limited in doing. Father, we're asking for true success. We're asking while they improve in their academics, their spiritual lives will be drawn closer to you. Lord, I pray that their walks through or all ways will draw them closer to a God who will be their teacher, not only on this earth, but even in the earth made new. We thank you for our teachers, hardworking teachers, and supportive parents who are behind these children. We pray, Lord, that you'll continue to be with us. And may we together, as we work with you, Lord, see these children excelling from strength to strength. We know, Lord, that you're able to do it. You have done it in time past. We have the testimonies. We've heard the testimonies. And we know, Lord, that you're able to do it again for us today. So we leave them in your care and ask you to truly have your own sweet way with them. And may, at the end of their journey at our institutions, they will testify that while I was attending the Port Maria High, the Portland High, the Busby Academy, I really was drawn close to God, and I've seen where God work a miracle in my life. May that be their testimony. May they never cease to give you praise, because they would have recognized that it was only because of you why they succeeded. Thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayers. Thank you for the miracles that you will wrought in their lives. And we continue to look to you, Lord, as you will bless us continually. We pray with thanksgiving in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. We will now be favored with a special musical item by Avadon Clark, after which Zalia Johnson, also another student, she will take us through the passage of meditation.
I hear the Savior say, thy strength will be small. Child of weakness, watch and pray, find in me thine all in all. Jesus paid it all to me, my Lord. Did and let the mountain send me up and let us know. Lord, now indeed I find thy power and thine alone can change the leper's heart and melt the heart of stone. Jesus paid it all to him my own. Sin and love, the gifts and stay, we walk it right as long. And when before the throne I stand in incomplete. Jesus died, my soul to save. My needs just to receive. Jesus paid it all to him my own. Sin left a crimson stain. He walked it white as snow. Oh, praise on, who paid my debt and raised his life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised his life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised his life up from the dead. Oh, praise the one who paid my debt and raised his life up from the dead.
Thank you very much, Abaddon. Jesus paid it all. Aren't you grateful for the great sacrifice that God's son, that him dying on the cross? Aren't you grateful for what he did for us? If you are grateful, please just type amen in the chat. I did say before that Zalia will be taking us through the passage of meditation, but it will be Zalon Johnson. It's over to you, Zalon.
Thank you, Mrs. Denise. The Bible passage is taken from Matthew 19, verse 14. It says, "But Jesus said, let the children come to me, but don't stop them. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to those who are like these children." This is a portion of the Lord's word.
Amen. Amen. Now, Do you want to know a bit more of what is happening at our noble institution? Well, you have no need to fear, because we have prepared a special video just for you. So I want you now to turn your attention to the video presentation that will be shared. Okay, so we will move on as we try to sort out the video for you. Now, here at the school, the Port Maria High End Preparatory School, we have many testimonies to give, and you would have heard from a parent and a past student of this institution. Now it's time for you to hear from a current student. He is a student of grade 8, form 2, Alton James Rose, and he will share a testimonial about his time being at the Port Maria High and Preparatory School. And let me just share a secret with you. Alton is coming from prep school. He is coming from grade one. So Alton has a lot to share, a lot of stories to share with you. Please lend him your ears.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Alton James Rose, and I am a grade 8 student at the Port Maria High and Preparatory School. And this evening, I'll be sharing my experience with you with Christian education. So, Christian education has impacted my life in many different ways. It has helped me to be more confident. It has helped me to become bold, and I am not afraid to speak up, especially when I see injustice. Being in the environment where children education is taught makes me comfortable and speaks and helps me to express my true self. I am able to grow spiritually because we put God first in everything we do. It has helped me to develop a deeper understanding of who God is, how God operates, or how God works. Christian education has helped me to develop a more meaningful relationship with God. At Port Maria High and Preparatory School, where Christian education is taught, the environment is peaceful. So I find the teachers to be very kind, compassionate, and understanding. The atmosphere also is a friendly and happy one. I look forward in going to school each day. We have lively and meaningful devotions. We have activities such as Week of Prayer, Day of Kindness. When I participate in these activities, it makes me draw closer to God. Coming from a Christian home and going to a Christian school has helped me to develop strong characters, such as love, kindness, patience, and forgiveness. I truly feel privileged because Christian education develops the whole man academically, mentally, physically, and emotionally, and most importantly, spiritually. I cannot testify about somewhere where Christian education isn't taught, but I have watched on the news and some of the things I see at other schools experiencing, I can testify that it does not happen at my school because this is an institution where God is always in the lead. And as I can see, as I'm going to end, I truly feel blessed and privileged to be a recipient of Christian education.
Wow, thank you, Alton. Thank you. Such a wonderful testimony that was. I want to speak to my adults now, those who have children but are not sending them to one of the three schools in the Northeast Jamaica Conference. I have a question for you. What are you waiting on? Didn't you just hear what Alton said a while ago? He is not only impacted spiritually, but here at our different schools in the conference, we cater to the whole man. We cater to them academically, the students, to academically, spiritually, emotionally, mentally, and socially. we cater to the whole being. So let me ask the question again. What are you waiting on to enroll your child or your children in one of your institutions? I implore you right now to please think about it. Think about it. Think about enrolling your child or children to whether it be the Port Maria High, the Port Maria High and Preparatory School, or the Buff Bay Academy, or the Portland High and Preparatory School. And if you are not living in this region, then we have other institutions scattered across this island. So please think about it. Now, I'm sure that you have been blessed from we started this program, from the various items, the song service, the musical item that was offered, and from the testimonials. And now you are going to be blessed even more. We have reached the point of the program where we are going to hear a word from the Lord. And God has chosen a special individual to deliver his words. Lorian Gilmore, a fifth former, will share with you, give you some information about this person who the Lord has chosen. After Lorian does the introduction of the speaker, we will have the meditation song by Kyra Scarlett, a Ford former.
Kind-hearted, compassionate, spiritual, warm, and sincere are a few adjectives to describe our speaker for this evening. Our speaker is a woman who loves children and young people. She loves the Lord and has a strong desire to see young people saved in his kingdom. Our speaker is the wife of a minister and the mother of one of our grade one students. She serves the school as the head of the kindergarten department. Our speaker is none other than Mrs. Moya McGregor Williams. Her passion for service expands beyond the 6 years that she has been serving the Port Maria High and Preparatory School. This evening, she will be sharing with us the word that the Lord has laid on her heart. Let us attentively listen as God's servant speaks to us.
Anybody can hear?
You feel you're walking all alone, but he is there, no doubt. When the storm around you rages and you're tossed down and fall, when you're faced with life decisions, you're not sure which way to go. Stand still and let go. Standing still is hard to do. When you feel your heart is beating for you, stand still and let God move. When the enemies surround you and the walls are closing in, when the tide is swiftly rising and you wonder where he's been, friend, there never was a moment that his arms would reach you. You can rest assured and be secure that he's moving right now. Stay still and let go of you. Standing still is hard to do. When you feel the light being stand still and let go. When you feel
amen, amen. Thank you, Miss Gilmore, for your kind words of introduction, and thanks to Miss Scarlett for such beautiful singing. Good evening, everyone. It is such a privilege for us to be here this evening on this platform, sharing in this Education Week experience. God has done so much for us as a people, as educators, and as his children. And so this evening, we are delighted to share with the world what God is doing in Northeast Jamaica Conference and through the schools he has planted here in this part of the vineyard. I am happy to be in this seat this evening, and I pray that God will truly speak to somebody's heart this evening so that they may receive a blessing and they may be enthused about the work God has planned for them. I invite you to bow your heads with me as we pray. Our kind Heavenly Father, we're truly grateful for this opportunity you have given unto us this evening. We pray now, Lord, that you will speak to our hearts. Give us an open mind, Lord, and may we accept your words. Thank you for what you have in store for us. And we pray that your name will be glorified in this worship session. For we have asked in Jesus' name, amen. Our theme is Let the Children Come. And as I thought about it,
I started to think about a child who is happy to see someone. And so the question came to mind. Have you ever seen a little child who is happily on his or her way to meet someone they love, someone they may not have seen for a little while, but this person they enjoy being around? They're just bubbling with joy. They can't wait for that little pat on their head, that warm hug, that peck on their cheek or on their little forehead. They're excited. And so the Bible tells us of a story in Matthew chapter 19. And we're going to begin at verse 13, where people brought little children to Jesus for him to place his hands on them and pray for them. Your aunt, grandma, or maybe even your parents whom you have missed for a little while is one thing. But to be going to the one who speaks life and prosperity for him to lay hands on you and to pray for you is a total different story. So I can just imagine the little ones gladly awaiting the opportunity to get close to Jesus. They may have been following him around with their parents day after day, but may not really have gotten the opportunity to go close to him. And so the moment mommy said, "Go over to Jesus so that he can bless you," they just sprung to their feet with great excitement. They can't wait to sit on his lap, give him a little hug with their tiny hands. And I can just imagine the little shy ones. They may still have their fingers on their lips while mommy having to give them a little push and take them a little closer. But despite the shyness, they really want that closeness with Jesus. They want their little touch too. They want to be close to this new found friend, Jesus. Only to have their bubbles burst by the seemingly not so friendly disciples, as they say, "Please go back to your mommy, little ones. Jesus is a bit tired right now. He has been teaching all day. Give him a break. Let him get some rest." But what did Jesus say in verse 14? He said, "Let the little children come to me and forbid them not." In other words, don't hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. Now, it's against this background that we have the blessing of babies in our church today. But I'm not here to do a baby blessing. It would be quite interesting to have one here online, but that's not what we are about this evening. It is Education Week, and this evening we are saying, "Let the children come." Telling the children to come implies there is a place for them. There is apparently enough room for them, since the command did not specify how many children should come. So, as for me, I would say, let all the little children come. But where? Let all the little children come where? Where exactly
are they going? One may think they are being called to church. Yes, it could very well be, depending on who is doing the calling. But the command was to let the children come to Jesus. Now, the truth is, there are many children who really do not go to church. And it's a sad reality in the society in which we live. It is very sad. Too many of our children have no idea what church is about. They are unable to go on their own. And oftentimes, those who are responsible for taking them do not have an interest in God. Many are the excuses for the children not to be in church. While there is no law in our land that says you may be fined or imprisoned if your child does not go to church, there are laws concerning our children going to school or obtaining an education. In the document concerning the child's right, it says, every child has the right to education. So this means we dare not deprive them of an education. We dare not say, I am keeping my child at home, homeschooling my child without the proper documents and going through the right process in doing this. God forbid if somebody decides to take us before the law for keeping our children at home. We would really be in some serious trouble. But do we get in trouble for not taking them to church? After all, Christ says, let the children come unto me. So since God in his infinite wisdom knew that there would be no law concerning the children going to church, he would have already established an education system for his children that they may still have the opportunity to come to him. And that is why we are here this evening saying, let the children come. To where are we saying, let the children come? To a place where the image of God may be restored in them. To where are we saying, let the children come? To a place where there are godly educators who don't just teach Bible stories, but all other subject areas are integrated into a Christ-centered curriculum. To where are we saying, let the children come? To a place where the harmonious development of man is fostered. This is where we are saying, let the children come. To a place where God is. To a place where it's not the principal who have established it. It's not the president of the conference who has established it, but to an institution that was planted by God himself for his children. It was quite gratifying to have the children come to Jesus. And so when the disciples started turning them away, not only were the children disappointed, but so was Christ. And I believe that when we go into the communities, when we have education day and we go into the communities, we go into our churches and we promote our Seventh Day Adventist Christian education, our schools, and people criticize and complain and refuse to take their children to God's schools,
the schools that God has established for his children to come to him, I believe God is displeased. He is disappointed. And so I am encouraging someone who is still wondering, is it worth it spending all this money when the government has made education free? Don't deny them this opportunity to come to Jesus. There is enough room for them. There is a place for them in our schools. There is a place for them in God's heart. And there's a place for them in God's kingdom. They are not too young to die. They're not too young to live for Christ. And so Christ is still saying, today, in our day, let the children come. The truth is, Christ is coming back not just for adults, but he wants the children to be able to take their rightful places in his kingdom. He is coming back for characters that reflect him. And I believe that there is a work of transformation that is being done through our schools. Students who have been brokenhearted. God has come through for them in our schools. When their families have failed, when friends have failed, some of them, they have been to other schools. And coming into our schools, they have a different experience. They not only experience friendly people, a great staff, wonderful students, but they come in contact with Jesus through the varying programs we have. They would have seen how God is able to work in their lives. And so God still has a work to do on many. Some of them are not there yet. And so we are telling you this evening, let them come. Some are here and God is still working with them. Our schools are the tools in God's hands. So I say again to somebody this evening, let the children come. To us as teachers who are here this evening, we have been called to this ministry, and it is a great and awesome task that we have. We have a big job to do, teachers. And I pray that we recognize that the children are not coming to us. When we say, let the children come, we are echoing God's call. We are echoing Christ's call. And so while they are in our care, we must be true representatives of Christ. They should see Jesus in us. The way we walk, the way we talk, the way we dress, the way we teach must bring the children closer to God. This is what Christ expects. This is how Christ is calling them to himself through us. So despite the sometimes failing grades and the bad attitudes we may get, the love of Christ must still be seen and heard, even in correcting them. So I encourage my fellow colleagues, let us ask God for the strength that we need to rightly do what he asks of us to do as we bid them to come.
Our students are not literally coming to Jesus, who is physically sitting in their classrooms, but they are coming to the Jesus who will shine through us. Let it not be said that though the students came to a Seventh-day Adventist school, they never got the opportunity of coming to Jesus because of the disciples in us. But instead, let them see Jesus who will bid them come. Being a teacher is a very serious and important calling. And as we take on this job, it is basically one of the roles Jesus had while he was here on earth. And so we are acting on his behalf. So healing should come through our teaching. Hope should come through our lessons as our students see Jesus in every aspect of their learning. So if we don't know how to teach in such a way that even in math lessons, Christ is seen, we should ask for divine intervention, because God's children must get an opportunity to come to him. And parents, it is not just the job of the teacher to bring the children to Christ. You have a part to play too. It is a combined effort. All of us have a role to play. And so, though you may not be sending them out to church or taking them to church, if you have not yet given them that opportunity to come to Christ, we are saying, through our schools, take them to Jesus Christ. He is still interested in saving children today. And too many of our children are going down the wrong path. And so he is depending on us. He is depending on you as a parent to do what is right. Send your child to an institution where Christ is the center of learning, so they may know what it is God requires of them. It is not a teacher just getting up and teaching the languages and math and science and all those. While those are important, the aim is for the students to develop a character that will fit them not just for this life, but for the life to come. We are living in a sinful world, and it is time to pack up things and go home. And so before it is eternally too late, we say to you, let the children come. Let us do our part in giving them the opportunity they need to go to Christ. Let it not be said that as a parent, you have become a disciple, but it is your job, as the parents of the Bible did. They sent their children to God. They brought their children to God. So I encourage you this evening to take your child or your children to God. Let the little children come. May God continue to use us as we strive to mold young minds and bring them closer to him. May God help us as we continue to work with him in bringing these children closer to God, so that one day they too may have a place in his eternal kingdom. God bless you.
Amen. Amen. What a word. What a word. I am sure that you were blessed by the message that Mrs. Williams just shared with us. Please be reminded that it is almost time for the Lord to come. And when God comes, when he returns, he will not just return for the adults of this world, but the children. He will also return for the children as well. So therefore, I join with Mrs. Williams and to tell you, to ask you to let the children come. Mr. Kelly will now sing the appeal song, after which Mrs. Scott Brown will pray.
Are you tired of chasing pretty rainbows? Are you tired of spinning round and round? Wrap up all the shattered dreams of your life at the feet of Jesus, lay them down. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, broken toys. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus, and he will turn his sorrows into joy. He never said there'd always be sunshine. He never said there'd be no rain. He only promised a heart full of singing about the very things that once brought pain. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus. Shattered dreams, wounded hearts, broken toys. Give them all, give them all, give them all to Jesus, and he will turn his sorrows into joy. And he will turn his sorrows into joy. Will turn your sorrows into joy.
Let's pray.
Great and marvelous are thy works, O Lord. Lord, we come this evening out of gratitude to you because you have been such a great God. We have seen your hand at work in our institutions, Lord. We have seen how you have moved, how you have guided and helped as your institutions move strength to strength. We pray, Father, that you will help us to recognize that through eternal ages, the work that we do, the decisions that we made and that we have made to be workers and parents and students in your institution will be recorded forever. Lord, not just the children, but all of us are eager to receive the blessing from you.
are eager to move closer to you and to be your children. We pray, Heavenly Father, that the parents will keep the children near, that the parents will stay near you. We pray, Lord, that the workers will keep near you. We pray that the decision that we make to be workers and parents and leaders and students in your institution will be of such that it will make such a difference in our lives. So at this time, Lord, we thank you for the privilege of coming together like this. And we thank you for reminding us of the great work that we have to do and the great calling that we have as workers and students and parents. Father, we ask that you pronounce a blessing on us, that you will guide and keep and protect and help us as we seek to follow your mandate. And we pray that the students will really be prepared, not just for this life, but for the life to come, is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.
Ah, my heart, it was indeed touched this evening. What a great way to end Sunday. Wouldn't you agree? If you were touched as well, if you were blessed by the singing and by the spoken words, let me see you just type in the chat, PTL, praise the Lord. I'm sure that you were indeed blessed by the happenings of this evening. We are nearing the end of our program. But you remember that video that I mentioned earlier that we prepared specifically for you, our viewers? Well, it is now ready. So I invite you to just tune in and watch what it has and is taking place at the Port Maria High and Preparatory School.
Let's fight for a cure! need help spiritually, come to the altar. If you need God's help with your work, come to the altar.
Jesus. I pause just to give one more person that opportunity to give their hearts to Jesus.
Winning this, big up the yellow horse.
Congrats.
The race was pretty stressing, but I kept on going, and then I came first.
My strategy was to run, stop, and look behind me.
How much did you come?
First.
How do you feel?
Happy.
I took the lead from the start to the finish. I was out of breath most times, but I believe in God.
I'm saying for you is important to keep a focus, keep a easy mind. First.
Breathe.
I hope you enjoyed the video that was just shared with you. You see, there are many, many things happening at this institution, and we have 3 more months left in the school year, and I'm certain that there will be a lot more happening at the school. See, I told you we not only cater to the spiritual aspect, the spiritual part of the students' lives, but we also cater to the social part of the students' lives. Now, Mrs. Andrews, it is over to you.
I hope you're hearing me. Thank you for joining us this evening. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And sincere thanks to all our participants. We are happy to have you online and right here at 88 Senate Street. We are still a beacon of Seventh-day Adventist Christian education, where we are empowering lives and we are building individuals to have their rightful place in the kingdom of God. So we invite you to join us again on Wednesday, where Portland High School will lead out in our service, and also on Friday for our Vesper service with the Buff Bay Academy. I know that this week you'll be richly blessed. I know that this week, as we highlight our students, as we showcase our institutions, you will join us on board at the 3 institutions, or one of the 3 institutions in the Northeast Jamaica Conference. Remember, friends, remember, colleagues, remember, parents and students, let the children come to Christ. And with him in the lead, we must succeed. God bless you and see you soon. The Brumfields will take us out. Have a great night.
Never said that I would give you silver or gold, or that you'd never feel the fire or shiver in the cold, but I did say you'd never walk through this world alone. And I did say, don't make this world your home.
I didn't say the fear wouldn't find you in the night, or the loneliness was something you'd never have to fight, but I did say, I'll be right by your side. And I did say, I'll always help you fight. 'Cause you know I've made a promise that I intend to keep. My grace will be sufficient in every time of need. My love will be the anchor that you can hold on to. This is the promise. This is the promise I've made to you. I didn't say the friends would never turn their backs on you, or that the world around you wouldn't see you as a fool, but I did say, like me, you'll surely be despised. Yeah, 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 yeah. And I did say, My ways confound the wise.
I didn't say you'd never taste the bitter kiss of death, or have to walk through chilly Jordan to enter into rest. But I did say I'd be waiting right on the other side. And I did say I'll dry every tear you cry, 'cause you know I've made a promise that I've prepared a place, and someday sooner than you think you'll see me face to face, and you'll sing with the angels and the countless multitude. This is the promise, this is the promise I've made to you.
Sometimes it seems so challenging and stressful to deal with the students, even our own children at times, but God promises that He will give us the strength.
So just keep on walking, don't turn to the left or right, and in the midst of darkness, let this be your light, that hell can't separate us, and we're gonna make it through. This is the promise, this is the promise I've made to you. This is the promise I made to you.
This is the promise that God has this made to us.
This is a promise.
And we can stand assured that His promises are true.
This is the promise.
They never fail.
This is the promise. This is
keep holding the promise on to His promises.
Belongs to such as these, for the kingdom will come, and like children we believe. Oh, do not hinder them, let them come and dance and sing, and let the children come to me. Let them come, or let them laugh. Let him jump or sing and dance. Come to me, let the children come to me. In each of them I take delight, they are precious in my sight. Let the children seek my face, let the children find my grace. From every tribe and every race, let the children seek my face. Yeah. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these. For the kingdom will come when like children we believe. Oh, do not hinder them, let them come and dance and sing. Let the children come to me. Oh, let the children come to me. Let the children come to me. Each of them I take deep.